preparation for the major was, I think we was all prepared, but when we got to the major, not having the coach there with us, I think the actual preparation at the major wasn't as good as what it could have been. And the expectation was, I think, was just to get out of groups because it was our first international event together. So I think it was just about building team chemistry and hoping to get out of groups.
And I mean, I can't speak for other people, but I think obviously it was my first major. I've been to a Prem LAN before, but that was years ago, and it's the levels to it. So obviously I was nervous for it.
Well, comparing the Mexico to like tournament without the pandemic, like way before, it was, well, let's be honest, it was way worse because of no fans, no audience. It wasn't as fun to play, if you know what I mean. To be fair, I think it might have made people more nervous, some of them at least, because if you hear the audience shout out your name during the game and stuff, you get more hyped. You want to play the game more, you want to prove yourself more. So without that aspect, it might be a bit more difficult sometimes.
So obviously not having the coach at the major does have an effect at with the preparation at the major itself, especially with when we're playing the actual official games and we need the timeouts. We don't have the coach behind us with his POV, and he can't really give us his feedback about the in-game, so that did have a real big effect on our performance.
I mean, at the Mexico Major, there was like so many like rounds which were like close, but we lost a lot of clutch situations, especially against SSG. Like that cafe game, we lost about 3 or 4 1v1s, and if they go differently, then we win. So like it's different, because then against other teams, we will do like wrong decision making, like the actual attack. But against like, if there's not much you can do with, okay, we lost our 1v1s today. There's not much you can say after that.
Obviously, that's going to have a real big effect on us specifically, because it's our first LAN together. So less games is always going to be worse, especially for us. So I think it had a real big effect on our performance overall. Less games played, less chances to get out of groups.
I think it was after the third game we lost. We knew we was already out, so it was kind of disappointing, especially with like all the results being like close. With like first game was 8-7, next game was 7-5, and these were against like teams like Furia and SSG, who've got like a lot of LAN experience. So I think at the start it was disappointing, but after a couple of hours we realised that this is our first event as a team. Literally, I'd never met apart from Doki, I didn't meet anyone else in the team before this. So it was a good learning curve, good experience for us.
I think it was maybe more about psychology, because with our gameplay wise, I don't think we really changed much. We just stick to what we was doing stage 1 and 2. You know, everything was working in those 2 stages. We had really good 2 stages. So I think we just stuck to our game plan and our gameplay. And I think it was more psychology, more mental wise for us. Majority of us, me, Doki and Nathan specifically, we have a strong friendship bond. So. And saves and secretly when you're in person it is different, you know, you're talking to each other more and stuff, and you're just playing more games as well together. So I think just talking and playing games more with each other, I think.
1D, making it such a nuisance to try and fight back.
The Doki prophecy, it's coming true from the balcony last night. He was telling us. He said it.
This poor guy.
He said, watch, now that this game means nothing, we're going to win it.
I think like in moments of like really hard, like loss and defeat, it's just important to kind of, you know, have a joke or like maybe keep the mood up, just keep people focused and distracted from like the negative stuff going on. Because if you're just completely focused on being bad and losing, it's just you're going to keep losing. So it's important to get the mood up and make sure everyone's like, okay.
Yeah, you can keep that in. Do you want to do this interview? Hey, you. Yeah, you.
I think when you watch a lot of teams, like especially like Brazilians, they have a lot of like fun. They look like they're having a lot of fun with each other. Like the mood is always generally good, and like most of LATAM teams as well. They have boot camp. They live in a house together permanently. So obviously they know each other, they got good relationships with each other, which I think is a key point of any team if you want to achieve something. It's not just about being a team, I think it's about the outside of the game, being actual friends, having actual relationships with people, things in common.
Well, right after Mexico, we had a talk and we swapped up some roles because obviously people were getting bored of them and stuff like that. So we had some freshness in the team. Well, that didn't work out perfectly, as you can see in stage three, but we're still trying all the new stuff, and we are still trying all the new stuff, to be fair. We are still changing constantly to find that balance.
Where we'd gone wrong in the second stage, I don't think there was a thought going through anyone's mind that we need to make changes or anything to do with roster swaps. But we just know that we need, as soon as we got back, we need to put more work in. We didn't even have a long break after Mexico. We had, because me and Byron and Doki went to Ukraine straight after, so we started screaming again just after we got back. But I mean, just watching the rest of the major and seeing other teams go on to like the group stage, to like the playoffs and the finals, and you know, it was won the Mexico major. It was team one. I mean, they weren't expected to win the major at the start. No one really guessed that they would win it. I mean, they were a good team. And when we spoke to them after the event, they were like just saying how much work they put in, and I guess that was one of the main motivations for me.
The mood's not always great when you lose and you go out of a tournament, but we did realise this is our first international event together, so it is a learning curve for us. So we just took it, we learned from it, so it prepares us better for Invitational, which is the main event that we want to do well at.
I think we kind of pushed it aside and said, like, it's our first LAN event as a team. Let's just use it as experience instead of like being so like heartbroken that we are, you know, losing so early. I think the only thing it's going to prepare us better for Invitational coming up. So it's a good experience and not much else to say. Like, we played bad, but we'll play better because of it.
Yep.
How to be professional gamer.
Mm-hmm.
By Fnatic.
Well, the first couple games were great. The first game started off against G2. It was a really clean game from us. And then heading into the next couple games, maybe I think it was a bit complacency, a bit more maybe. I think maybe everyone's mindset was a bit not as focused in the game as what we should have been, because we started, you know, we was ahead in the next upcoming games as well. And then we let them slip away, and then I think it just had a chain reaction on our next games, because losing from Mexico Major as well, leading into stage three, start losing, it does build up, so yeah.
I think for me personally, because I was at home and obviously I had like a lot of distractions, I could say, especially with me losing motivation for the game. I think I can speak for me personally, I can speak for some others in the team as well, with the game and the direction it's going in. But I think if we was at boot camp and we were all together, I think we'd more like motivate each other to play the game a bit more. Because that, in my opinion, that was the reason why stage three went so badly, because obviously we terrible individual performances and just the general team mood, because we had some people that were putting in a lot of effort wanting to like achieve everything, and then we have people like were just not enjoying the game, didn't really care. So I think with a boot camp, yeah, it would have made a difference.
Starting off with a VP game, I think going into the bank game, obviously the way they played versus us, it was a bit more fast paced, a bit more like surprise like moves that we're not really used to. And I think when teams play like that against us specifically, we kind of get a bit frustrated, get a bit head loss.
Look how aggressive he plays, Nathan. Watch.
And then in the next game's Vitality game, we started off on bank again, really good start, 3-0 up. And then they took a timeout, which I think broke our momentum a bit. And then it just spiraled away from there. And they just started playing a bit like our VP did, with the aggressive picks, aggressive plays, and et cetera like that. BDS, I think we played them on Clubhouse, which is just a really strong map for them, and for us previously it's just been a really weak map for us. I can't remember the last time we won it, and Schalke was just on one of those games where he's just a beast and you can't really win against him.
Ubisoft released that documentary on VDS. You could tell from the video, like, they're all mates, they all get along, they have no, if they have an issue, they'll just speak about it. It's like, there's no, people won't take criticism personally, stuff like that. But, bloody hell, my mind's gone blank again. I thought you started that one, I forgot that. It's about BDS, wasn't it? And yeah. Why they're better than us. Well, and another reason was the just general motivation to play. Because I think that was the only thing, but last stage, when, say for example, I wasn't playing, like, I go on Twitch and see some of their players streaming the game, playing the game more than I was. So it's just a general effort thing. They were just putting in more time and effort than us.
The heroic game, the last game for us, was an 8-7 win. Personally for me, I'm not satisfied with that result. It should be a way cleaner game for us, 7-2s, especially on Villa, where it's a more structured-based map, which suits us way more than it would a heroic, because they have more solo players, solo crouch walks, etc. So for us, it was a must-win game. Obviously, happy that we won it because it secures the invite spot, but against a team like heroic, definitely not satisfied with an 8-7 result now.
The pickup, and now it is just Shukri left looking for the first behind the bar, but it's Nate that locks it off. Na'Vi, they find the end of a frustrating game for them, but heroic made them earn every single round.
Yeah, I mean, I just think in general, like, no matter what, I mean, the way I think now is no matter what game, what direction the game is going in, like, there's always going to be someone trying to put in more work than you, and that's exactly what happened. More teams are just putting in more work than us individually and team wise, and that was just the difference in stage three. I was more upset about our stage three, let alone missing the major, because it was like a hard reality check after stage three of things you cannot afford to do whilst playing at this level. Obviously, I think we were all disappointed in not making the major, but I just think after stage three, where we finish eighth, you know, like, from going first to finishing top four twice in a row and then going to eighth, it's not like, it's just not unlucky. That's down to us. That was just, we just knew we had to put in a lot of work after stage three.